Hi guys and welcome back to another VR review. Today I'm going to be reviewing Star Wars Tales from the Galaxy's Edge. Being a massive Star Wars fan, I was really excited to play this game after seeing the trailer. Let's see if it lived up to the excitement. First thing I noticed about this game is that it reminded me of the best recent Star Wars game, Jedi Fallen Order. Before you say, not in the gameplay but in the game structure, where you have missions in zones of collectibles scattered around and different routes to take. You can then later visit them after you've completed the game. Saying that, there's not much to do in these levels after you've completed the missions in them. It's still a nice concept to have in VR and sort of reminds me of the Walking Dead Saints and Sinners thinking about it. There are a couple of side missions and I would definitely recommend completing them, as the one you pick up from the cantina opens up a mission which is around 15 to 20 minutes long. I won't spoil it, but it's worth doing. Moving on to the combat in this game, it's okay, but nothing we haven't seen before. I probably enjoyed it more than others, being a Star Wars fan. Using the blasters was a dream come true. You have four blasters to pick up around the levels. These include a three round burst pistol, a high damage single fire pistol, which reminds me of how Han Solo's blaster, so admittedly I really enjoyed this one. You also have a shotgun and a full auto rifle. All these guns have a vent on them, which you have to pull back to let cool air in when the gun gets too hot. These weapons can be picked up off fallen enemies, or you can find them in supply boxes scattered around the map. I'll talk more about these later. One bit of the combat system I liked was the battle slash training droids. Around the levels, these can also be found in supply boxes, but they can't be found on fallen enemies. There is a normal type which just fires blaster lasers at enemies. There's a shield one, which does the same as the first one, but it has a shield around it and it also tags the enemies. And the last one is an exploding one. I think that one's pretty self-explanatory. These were good, but I feel like they could have done a bit more with them. I constantly found myself forgetting about them, as there wasn't much of a challenge. I didn't find them very necessary. There is also a hover pack mechanic in this game. It is pretty much the exact same mechanic as what you have in Trover Saves the Universe, where you can hover up into the air. It can give you an advantage in some battles, but it is mainly to access new areas. You can't move in the air when you get up there though, so it's a bit of a boring mechanic. They could have at least put some thruster mechanic in, so you can move a little in the air. That would have added some really fun and slick gameplay. You also have a multi-tool. It has a heat gun, ratchet, and an electric pulse on it. This can be used to open doors and supply boxes that are scattered around the levels. The puzzles to open them up could have been a bit harder. They may as well have not had them in the game, they were that easy. The gripe I have with this combat system on the whole though, is that if you strip back and take all the Star Wars skins off everything, like I said at the beginning, it's nothing we haven't seen before. It probably would have slipped under the radar if it didn't have the Star Wars name behind it. They had a real chance to change up the combat system, but they just played it safe. The characters you meet along the way make the game so much fun. At the start, you're introduced to Mubo. I think that's how you pronounce it. Mubo is the owner of the Droid Depot. This is a droid construction store in the Black Spire Outpost. He is a very likable and funny character, and he will be the one you interact with the most, as when you're out exploring the multiple levels, he is always chiming in over the intercom. He sort of reminds me of Russell from Half-Life Alyx, but more of a BTEC version. Don't get me wrong, he has his moments, but no one will ever come close to topping King Russell. You then go on to meet my favourite character in the game, Cecil Slack. Again, I think that's how you pronounce it. He is the owner and the bartender of the cantina. He is so likeable and never fails to make me laugh. With him being a bartender on Batuu, he has some stories to tell you and I would recommend you listen to them. You won't be disappointed. You also meet some very recognisable faces along your journey, which is really cool to see in VR. I won't spoil it, but you might have already seen them. The story is okay, but forgettable. You are being hunted by the Guavian Death Gang and their leader. She didn't really have anything to do with the story. It almost reminded me of the Espire 1 villain, but nowhere near as bad as that. No one can ever get it that bad. They could have just used her a bit more in the game and it would have made the experience better. Maybe even just learned a bit more about her background from Cecil Slack, or something along those lines. The game is also very short for the price. It was £18.99, and it only took around 3 to 4 hours to complete. I heard that they were going to be releasing new content in the future. That ain't too bad then, if the future content is free, but unfortunately you will have to pay for it. I know it may seem like I didn't like this game, but I really enjoyed the game. But as I thought about it and took the Star Wars skins off it, and just thought about how good the game could have been, it put things into perspective. So in conclusion, if you are a Star Wars fan or a newcomer to VR, you'll really enjoy the game. If you are willing to spend the money on the game and the future expansions, you will have a good time, I can guarantee you that. But there are a lot better games that you can buy for that price. So if you're on a budget, maybe scooch over to something like Pop 1. Thanks Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure you like, subscribe, and drop me a comment. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next one.